Today, my topic is project management outline and difficulty of Ping An Finance Center.
女士们，大家下午好，我是来自平安集团的。那么，因为时间有限呢，我接下来就直接开始讲我的正题。我们的题目是超高层项目管理的要点及难点。Okay.
This is project description. The height of the building is 600 meters, and the construction division is from mid 212 to mid 20 and 60. The size area is about 19,000 meters square. GFA 460,000 meters square. Foundation was mega pile with thick wall. Main tower structure was hybrid system composed of cold wall, outrigger, truss, and mega columns.
这边是关于这个项目的一个简介。首先的话，深圳平安城中心的高层达到600米，那么塔楼的主体计划，东西的话是从012年的中期到16年的中期，占地总面积呢，是约为1万9000平方米，建筑面积是46万平方，采用的是矩形装阀基础，主体结构采用核心孔，深地行架加巨柱的钢混组合结构体系。
Okay. We'll jump into the main session, master control management.
接下来首先给大家讲一下这个总控管理。
Since April 2012, the construction of tower structure was commenced, and the target completion date is in April 2016. In order to meet the tight program, it's required to perform construction cycle for 4 days per typical floor.
那么我们按照这个施工的工期的话，项目呢是从2012年的4月份正式开始，完工期呢是设定在2016年的4月份。为了满足这样的一个工期的话，我们必须要能够保证，在标准层的话，按照每层4天的速度，这个完成。
From this slide, you can find the annual progress target of the Ping An Finance Center since 2010. At the end of this year, the main core structure is scheduled to be complete, and the curtain wall to be complete to the 60 floor levels.
那么，这幅图的话是给大家展示了，从2010年到2016年一直到完工的时候，整个项目进展的一个情况。那么，到了今年年底的时候呢，整个项目的主体结构呢应该是能够完工，然后的话，幕墙呢也应该能够铺设到60层高度。Massive
investment. The total investment of the project is about 9.5 billion RMB. In order to realize the return target of investment, the project is targeted to be completed in mid-2016 as per the master program.
该项目的总投资呢是95亿人民币，业务项目管理团队和各参建团队必须按照总工计划目标于16年的中期竣工，这样呢才可以实现投资回报的目标。
The target of the standard. The Zhangtian Yao Prize, the Luban Prize of Quality Standard, and LEED Gold Rate of Energy Saving and Environment Protection required to be achieved for this project.
那么谈到质量标准的话，它要求达到詹天佑奖和鲁班奖的标准。那么节能及环保标准呢，要求达到这个 LEED 的标准。
We are talking about the construction critical part analysis.
接下来我跳到这一页，讲一下超高层施工关键路径分析。
Skyscraper was usually located downtown, and the site area is limited. But considering the construction of building structure, we are working at height. Reasonable construction sequence should be kept among structure, taking more decoration and elevation, so that the effective overlapping construction can be organized between contractors.
超高层项目选址呢，通常是位于一个城市市中心比较繁华的地段，那么所以呢，它施工现场的一个限制就比较多。单体建筑的施工楼层向高空纵向提升。 塔楼结构施工工序之间，以及结构与幕墙、机电、精装、电梯等专业施工需要保持合理的布局，以便高效组织交叉施工。
For installation of the steel structure, it is observed that the critical part is to keep the reasonable construction sequence between the steel core wall and conformal steel structure of frame, slab, concrete of frame, slab concrete of core wall, and concrete of mega columns in order to avoid restriction between each other of construction sequence.
关键路径这个为塔吊制造及安装核心筒塔模体系安装及调试需提前设计规划好塔吊选型及预埋安装方案，并确保塔吊按计划运抵现场并完成安装。
Another consideration is for the curtain wall. For installation of the curtain wall, it looks that the critical part to organize reasonable overlap construction in sequence of for brickwork, M&E work, decoration, etc. It is necessary to ensure overlap construction sequence of all professional contractors can be organized efficiently.
那么谈到这个外墙物理的这个安装呢，关键路径为各楼层区间合理组织墙体的这个切柱啊、机电、精装等专业单位交叉流水施工。该阶段需要总包等各方充分发挥各级设计协调的施工协调职能。
Okay, the next one regarding the lift shaft handover for the installation of permanent elevator.After topping up the main structure, the critical part is to overlap, remove temporary elevator, and install permanent lift simultaneously. As for lift installation skyscrapers, due to the high lift shaft, high installation accuracy, and high standard of the test, the lift installation duration is long, so lift handover schedule and the lift shaft partition installation program are little hand in advance.
关键路径为核心筒内施工电梯与正式电梯分批交叉拆除和安装。超高层电梯安装因井道高、安装精度和调试标准高，导致电梯安装周期长，需要尽早策划电梯井道移交方案和电梯井分段安装的方案。
And the third one, I would like to discuss about the challenge and risk.
第三部分呢，我想给大家分享一下挑战与风险。
As described above, project characteristics in section of necessity of project control management, skyscraper project management face the following challenges and risks: planning and procurement in one release scheme, a measure for facing for challenge and decreasing the risk and need.
正如前面所提到的项目总控管理的必要性。超高层项目管理的面临主要以下几个方面的挑战和风险，需要提前规划预判，制定相应应对挑战降低风险的方案或者措施。
Project progress challenges. Construction speed of tower structure is controlled, including the installation of tower crane, assembly of core wall come forward, fixing of the bar in depth, massiveWelding works of steel work, etc. The construction speed was around 10 to 15 days per floor, under 550 meters in height. Reasonable construction sequence was formed. Then the construction speed was accelerated to be 6 to 8 days per floor, between 50 and 150 meters. The construction speed was accelerated to be 4 days.Perform between 150 and 400 meters. But due to the transportation distance is increased, it was expected that the transportation efficiency of both tower crane and temporary elevator may be low. Then the construction period may be expected to be 5 days per floor, between 400 and 500 meters. So at the end, owing to removal of the time crane,and formwork of core wall in turn, the construction speed was estimate between 7 to 10 days before about 500 meters. So the next year is the most critical for Ping An project in order to speed up the progress.
超高层塔楼主体结构施工的速度大致如下，在高度50米以下的时候呢，因为塔吊和爬模的安装、钢筋密集、钢结构焊接量大等等原因呢，施工速度的话通常只有10到15天每一层。那么在高度达到50米到150米这个区间的时候呢，因为需要的话需要逐步拉开各道工序的一个隔离布局，施工速度呢是定为6到8天每一层。在高度达到150米到400米之间的时候，施工速度呢可以达到每一层4天。在400米到500米之间的时候呢，施工速度呢预计有5天每一层。那么对于最后当这个主体结构达到500米以上的时候呢，因为它塔冠部分，因为吊塔轮换拆除啊、爬模拆除等等，会导致这个施工速度下降到7到10天每一层。所以说我们这个平安项目明年是最关键的一年。
Project progress challenges. A huge amount of structural steel member, curtain wall units, fitting out material, construction waste, and large size equipment, etc., will occupy the transportation of hoisting machines and tower cranes. So, all the hoisting machines and tower cranes will be very busy there for transportation at night. Lift to be arranged reasonably. Some of lift shafts are occupied by the temporary elevators. After the temporary elevator are dismantled, then the installation of permanent lift will take long time to complete. After dismantling the ground temporary reinforced concrete support for hoisting machines, the main contractor faced to the material stacking and turning over to be more difficult.
大量的钢大量的钢构件、大量的幕墙单元板、大量的精装材料、大量施工垃圾和大型的机械设备等，将占用施工电梯及塔吊运输时间，导致塔吊和施工电梯运输非常的繁忙，需要合理的组织电梯进行运输。部分电梯井道呢被临时施工电梯占用，施工电梯拆除后正式电梯安装工期长。
This photo is shown to the traditional lift shaft installation is used the scaffold method. But in order to speed up the installation progress of this shaft, so it is proposed to adopt a long scaffold method.
那么这是一幅展示传统我们施工图的一个图片，然后是使用这个传统的脚手架的一种方式。那么因为我们工期比较紧的原因的话，我们是需要使用这种全新的方式。
So the following, we are talking about the contract purchase and cost control risk. Ping An Finance Center project involves so many specialties that there would be totally more than 100 companies, including consultants, engineers, contractors, and material suppliers, etc. It is necessary to work out procurement plans according to the project master plan. Try to simplify the procurement process and improve the procurement efficiency. Of course, it is necessary for design consultant to provide detailed and accurate drawing according to the master plan, so that the subsequent construction progress of the whole project can be fulfilled.
平安金融中心项目涉及的专业众多，设计顾问、监工、施工单位和供货单位等的总共超过100家，需要按照项目总控计划要求编制详细的招标计划，并尽量简化招标流程，提高招标效率。当然，也需要设计顾问按照计划呢提交尽可能详细准确的招标图纸和技术资料，以便满足后续项目整体的施工进度。
Apart from the cost control and other side for the project management, the quality is also important. Ping An Finance Center consider the earthquake and wind resistance capability energy saving and environmental protection index installation coordination during the construction stage. Building information modeling, BIM technology design and operation management, and this system implementation will benefit the project quality standard.
那么除了我们刚刚说到的成本以及项目管理的重要性之外，施工的质量的话，毫无疑问也是非常的重要。那么我们是使用了BIM BIM 这个系统，可以帮助我们更好的去管理项目，可以为我们的项目带来诸多的好处。
Some typical information for you.Regarding the energy installation. Before the energy installation, we can make use the BIM for reducing conflict, alternation, as well as simulation progress.
今天是给大家展示一下这个模拟的一个图形，就是怎么样去应用 BIM 这样的在能够在你实际的 就是这个实际的设备安装之前 ，MNE 安装之前的就能够从这个模拟当中看出它的效果。
Project safety risk. Falling from height is the high risk during the tripartite construction. Reasonable core wall and frame structure system should be selected during design stage so as to select safe and high efficiency frame framework during construction stage. Safety consideration, responsibility, and training, etc. are some important contents of project safety management.Enough full-time safety manager are necessary.
高层施工过程当中最大的风险呢，其实是高空坠落的风险，需要在设计阶段选择合理的核心统和外框结构体系，以便施工阶段配合选择安全高效的爬模体系。全员安全意识、安全责任、安全培训是项目安全管理的重要内容之一，需要配置足够专职的足够数量的专职安全管理人员。
There was high population from MTR station, bus station, and bus around the project site. There are several tile cams on site, multi-train simultaneous, would be so high risk of protective barrier for fall edge and hole, and high risk of protection for working ahead.
项目周边的地铁、公交、办公，地铁、公交、办公、酒吧人流量大，那么大型的塔吊设备呢，布局密集，超高层、多楼层，多工序、多人员的繁忙交叉施工，导致民间的这个防护、高空防坠风险大。
So from this map, you can realize that the location of Ping An is around the bar, MTR station, and business district, and the bus station. So in Ping An project, we will put.More and more emphasis on the safety issues.
那么你可以从这个示意图当中看到，我们平安项目它所在周边的包括购物、酒吧，那么包括了巴士，包括了这个公交车站、商务区还有地铁站，所以的话，对于我们平安项目来说，安全是至关重要的。
So we will provide some protective device to guarantee the safety of the project.
这就是我们刚刚展示的一些关于安全措施的一些图片，确保在整个施工期间能够做到安全。
So at the end of my presentation, I would like just conclude some experience from my experience.
最后呢，我想在这个演讲的最后阶段，基于我的这个经验呢，为大家做一个快速的总结。
Build a good team, form your team, and manage your team.So the project will succeed.
我觉得项目成功的前提呢是两点，一个呢就是你要去创建一个很好的团队，然后你要能很好的去管理你的团队，最后才能够获得项目的成功。
好，Thank you.
谢谢。